Artificial intelligence, AI. It has been around for decades, but in recent years, a convergence of big data, increased computing capabilities, and user demand has created a perfect storm where AI applications are evolving at a rapid pace. AI has a deep history that is ever-changing. It has the power to address different challenges and predict outcomes. A perfect artificial intelligence hasn't been created yet. But today, a subset of AI is being used everywhere. The most popular one is machine learning, which allows machines to learn from data without being programmed explicitly. Even the device which you use in your day-to-day life has some sort of machine learning embedded in it. Basic examples are voice-based recognition in smartphones, that is Google Assistant and Siri. In the modern world, AI is being asked to solve business challenges across operations, sales marketing, finance, accounting, and other areas where processes are inefficient, time-consuming, costly, and data-driven decision-making could dramatically enhance business operations. So artificial intelligence, or a subset of AI, is being used everywhere. But where did it start? Well, the AI of today is no longer the AI of the past, but the basics are the same. Feed data to the machine, then ask questions with variations. The better the data, both in quality and quantity, the better the chance of getting the right answers. The earliest substantial work in the field of artificial intelligence was done in the mid-20th century by the British logician and computer pioneer Alan Turing. In 1935, he described an abstract computing machine consisting of a limitless memory and a scanner that moves back and forth through the memory, symbol by symbol, reading what it finds and writing further symbols. Turing's conception is now known simply as the Universal Turing Machine. All modern computers are in essence universal Turing machines. Turing gave quite possibly the earliest public lecture to mention computer intelligence, saying, "What we want is a machine that can learn from experience," and that the possibility of letting the machine alter its own instructions provides the mechanism for this. In 1958, the Lisp programming language was invented at MIT by John McCarthy. Lisp is considered as one of the languages that is best suited for developing AI applications. Then years later, in 1968, a programmer called Richard Greenblatt built an intelligent knowledge-based chess-playing program which managed to achieve a Class C rating in tournament play. This chess-playing program was a forerunner for several other AI applications, including programs that beat the chess world champion. Another important milestone for AI was in 1979, when Internist, a knowledge-based medical diagnosing program, was developed that could leverage clinical knowledge to reach its diagnosis. Another path-breaking moment was in 1997, when the world watched IBM's Deep Blue chess machine defeat the then world chess champion, Garry Kasparov. In the same year, the first official RoboCup soccer tournament was organized with the participation of almost 40 teams of interacting robots. After that, we never stopped. Soon we got Google, one of the most known companies pioneering in AI today. Currently, every tech company has projects revolving around machine learning. It's everywhere, and its use case will increase with its intelligence. In day-to-day life, including your smartphones, you are actually interacting with multiple machine learning interfaces. One of them is vacuum cleaners. They use AI-based controllers in order to provide thorough coverage of the space to be cleaned. AI technology enables vacuum cleaners such as iRobot's Roomba to adapt to real-world clutter and furniture. Next up, there are smart cars. These vehicles have lots of features, which include automatic braking, anti-lock braking systems, ABS, collision avoidance systems, alerts about pedestrians, and intelligent cruise controls, and more. Today, almost every car manufacturing company has some of these features in their mid-range and premium segment. Not only this, most car manufacturers are implementing roadmaps for rollout self-driving vehicles by the end of 2021. In gaming, graphic card manufacturers such as Nvidia are using AI for their DLSS. Deep learning super sampling is rendering technology that increases graphic performance using dedicated Tensor Core AI processors on GeForce RTX GPUs. While DLSS 1.0 was complete trash, DLSS 2.0 is pretty good. It works by rendering fewer pixels and then using AI to construct sharp, higher resolution images, thus better performance and good visuals. So what does the future of AI look like? AI will continue to evolve in a way that will enable new disruptive business models and functionalities. It will also play a key role in improving quality of life by enabling humans to complete tasks more efficiently and in less time. In this direction, emerging deep learning technology is expected to play a key role in analyzing more inputs in a timely fashion, while at the same time identifying complex patterns beyond what machine learning can currently provide. AI will be increasingly embedded in devices in various contexts, including cars, consumer devices, search engines, and more. We can expect most of the future devices that comprise the Internet of Things to employ AI capabilities. People will increasingly get services from machines rather than humans due to their efficiency and zero-error performance. Personal assisted robots will proliferate and start helping people accomplish more tasks. The advent of AI-enabled self-driving cars will reduce the count of accidents significantly, saving millions of lives and leading to huge economic savings. There have been a ton of developments towards AI in recent years, including Tesla's own self-driving tech, which you can watch by clicking this I button. We can't possibly cover all the AI technologies and their pros and cons in this video. This is just the first of a 5-part series of upcoming AI videos. Click that like button and subscribe. Don't forget to turn on those notifications so you know when our next video gets released. Let us know in the comments below what you think AI will become. Have a great day.